So let's be honest, whatever comes out of Korea nowadays has to be a hit. Let it be K-pop or let it be their cars. So today, right over here, we have the brand new Hyundai Aura. And this is basically the sub-4 meter version of the i10 Nios. And I'll be very honest with you, the i10 Nios is hands down my favorite Hyundai on sale today. So let's see what these guys have in store for us. So one of my favorite parts about the new Aura has to be the front end. The front end has been inspired by the i10 N Line concept, which is like a super sporty version of the i10 Nios. And well, the front end kind of looks like that, doesn't it? We'll put a picture up here. And it has these hexagonal slats in the grille, which give it like a Lamborghini-esque vibe. But one really funny thing about it, come over here. Almost half of the grille is covered and the intercooler is only this big. So that's kind of weird, but like all in all, I think the front end looks like a very angry catfish, and has these little DRLs over here to give it a more muscular look. So this is the back end of the new Hyundai Aura, and well, not my favorite part about the car. Looks are subjective. If you like it, great, good for you, but not my personal favorite thing about the car. One thing that I've observed is that the taillights are actually exact opposite of the Dodge Charger SRT which you get in USA. So if you flip the image of a Dodge Charger SRT, you get the lights of the Aura. So what I don't like about the lights mainly is that instead of this chrome and black strip in the middle, maybe they could have just added the whole light strip all the way. That's just my personal take on it. It also has this kind of diffuser kind of vibe going on down there, but I don't know what to say about it. But at least it has a really big boot. The boot is 402 liters and it can fit basically anything. It's the second best in the category, coming second to the Tata Tigor, and well, yeah, it's a big boot. So all in all, what I think that Hyundai is trying to do is that they want to eradicate the taxi vibes that you got from the Accent. And they've gotten a fresh start with it. The Aura looks great. From the front, it looks really aggressive. The back, I don't know so much about. But my favorite part about the Aura has to be inside. Let's go and check it out. So this is my favorite part about the Aura. I mean, just look at the interior. It looks so expensive. You have these really nice cotton and leather seats. And I would rather say it gives me a very environment-friendly vibe with the cotton. And the steering wheel. The steering wheel has been inspired directly from cars like the Kona Electric and Santa Fe, which you get in the international market. The whole cabin does not have a single blank button, not a single one. Manufacturers are getting really good with spacing their buttons out and keeping it as minimal as possible. The infotainment. Infotainment is great. Obviously, Hyundai is going to give you all of the necessities that you need for 2020, like Apple CarPlay, Android Auto. You have these really nice texture over here on the dash, like a hexagonal. Again, very Lamborghini-esque, really weird. The gearbox has a nice gloss black section on top. But the only thing that I would say negative about the interior is maybe the instrument cluster. The instrument cluster has been taken out of the Santro. It is really minimal, yeah it is, but I do not like the design as of such. It has a lot of blank space going around. I think they could have filled it with more features, more information really easily. So that's the only thing that I do not like about the interior. But apart from that, you have these really cool Audi A3 kind of air vents over here on the driver and passenger side. And all in all, the interior is really nice. So one thing that I would like to say straight off the bat is that this AMT is really, really smooth. And I've driven my fair share of AMTs, yes. And this does not feel like an AMT at all. It feels like a DCT. The gear changes and everything else is so smooth down in the rev range that when you're driving it like a sane person, you just completely forget what you're driving. And for this car, that's a really, really good thing. Because first of all, in no way, in no sort of form, is this particular car an enthusiast car. It's not a driving machine. It's a really, really, really good commuting machine. That's what I have to say about it. So do not think of this as a driving machine that it's going to be really great to drive or something like that. Nope. It's a really good commuting machine. It is meant to go from place A to place B with the best economy and comfort. And I think so, when it comes to that, this car has 5 stars. The interior is so comfortable, so really well laid out. And I have to say, I know I spoke a little trash about the instrument cluster, but you know what? The minimal design is growing on me. You have a really big digital speedometer up front, which gives you a really good idea of how fast you're going. The tach is really big, and I think so, to be honest, in a car of this size, this is the most amount of information you need. I'll be very honest with you. The steering is also really, really good. I mean, it's not a performance steering wheel, so it doesn't have any feel. It's really, really numb. But for city use, it's super light. Turning radius, really good. One big downside about the driving experience, though, I have to say, is that the engine is not the most powerful thing around. 81 bhp, decent number, but if you are going to buy this car, especially in its petrol variant, I would suggest you to buy maybe the manual version, because you will have more control over the power. But one car that you have to really look out for, which Hyundai is getting to India, are the N line variants of the Aura and the i10. Those cars are going to have a 1-liter turbo engine producing 115 horsepower. So that is the car that you should look out for. So what are my final thoughts on the Aura? Well, I think so, the Aura really eradicates the taxi vibes that you get from the Accent or other sub-4 meter sedans, because this car has really good features, looks. You get these sick alloys also. So the car does not look like a taxi anymore. It looks like something that you would actually own. And all of it just ties in together to give you a nice little package. And the on-road price of this is, it's around 9.37 lakh rupees on-road. So good, kind of expensive, but it's a really good package. And if you want a sedan, don't want to spend a lot of money into like a compact sedan, this is not a bad option. Thank you so much for watching. Let us know what you think about the Aura. Like, share and subscribe, do all the formalities, and I'll see you in the next one.
Before you shut down this video, do check out Kothari Hyundai. Kothari Hyundai is one of the best showrooms if you want to buy a Hyundai car. They have a wide array of service centers and showrooms spread out all across Pune, and also they are the only Hyundai showroom in Pune which is assigned to sell the Kona Electric. So if you want to buy a Hyundai car, please do check them out.